Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic LODR. So it is an important topic for our Sebi Grade examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let's begin. So first of all, we will log into our website anujindal.in. Now here I will go to this link. So here in the quizzes section, I'll go to Sebi Grade-A. So here you can see quizzes are available for different topics for our Sebi Grade examination. So you can see there are two quizzes available for LODR, because LODR, it is an important topic. So that is why we have made two quizzes. So I have already discussed five important questions for LODR. Now in this video, I will be discussing further five most important questions. So you can watch the earlier video on important questions of LODR by clicking on the link being shown on the top right corner of the video. So now we will go to Securities Market LODR start quiz. So friends, let us see the first question. Regulation 23 of the LODR Regulations 2015 deals with related party transactions. Consider the below statements. So first of all, you need to know that LODR regulations, they were notified in the year 2015, right? So LODR regulations 2015. So let us read the statements one by one. Statement 1, all related party transactions require approval of the shareholders. So statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because all related party transactions, they require the approval of audit committee. So it is audit committee, and approval of shareholders is required only on those related party transactions which are material. So approval of shareholders is required in case of material related party transactions, RPTs. So what is the meaning of material? So material means those transactions which are of a large value, and the regulation state that those transactions will be called material which exceed 10% of the annual turnover of the listed entity, right? So statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 2, audit committee may grant omnibus approval for RPTs proposed to be entered by the listed entity for a period not exceeding 6 months. So first of all, you need to know what is the meaning of omnibus approval. So omnibus approval means one time approval. So audit committee can grant omnibus approval for related party transactions proposed to be entered by the company. But statement 2 is incorrect. Why? Because the period is not 6 months, the period is 1 year. So omnibus approval, it can be granted for a maximum period of 1 year. So why this regulation was introduced? Because it is not feasible to take permission from audit committee for every transaction, because it would lead to a lot of wastage of time and it would lead to delay in decision making. So that is why this provision of omnibus approval has been introduced, where the company or the listed entity can take approval from the audit committee for the transactions which it proposed to enter in the year, in the coming year. So this approval can be granted for a maximum period of 1 year. So that is why statement 2 is incorrect. And statement 3, a transaction with related party is considered material if it exceeds 10% of the annual turnover of the listed entity. So this statement is right. If the amount of transaction exceeds 10% of the annual turnover, then it will be called material. So statement 3 is correct. So the question is asking you which of the above statements do not conform to LODR regulations. So you can see statement 1 and 2, they are incorrect. So the correct option is option A, statement 1 and 2. Now question 2, LODR regulations contain provisions regarding various committees to be formed by listed entities. Consider the below statements. So LODR regulations, they contain provisions for the formation of various committees by the listed entities, like audit committee, nomination and remuneration committee, stakeholders relationship committee. So these regulations talk about various committees. So let us read the statements. Statement 1, chairperson of stakeholders relationship committee must be an independent director. So statement 1, it is incorrect. Why? Because chairperson of stakeholders relationship committee must be an non-executive director. So regulation 20, it talks about stakeholders relationship committee. So the chairperson must be a non-executive director. So statement 1 is incorrect. Statement 2, only top 500 listed entities as per market capitalization are required to form a risk management committee. So this statement is right. As per regulation 21 of LODR regulations, only top 500 listed entities as per market capitalization. So market capitalization is market price of one share into number of outstanding shares of the company. So top 500 listed entities as per market cap, they are required to form a risk management committee. So statement 2 is right. And what is the role of risk management committee? So risk management committee basically has to manage the risk. So it will assess the risk of the company from time to time and will install procedures or system to manage the risk or control the risk. So basically system of internal controls, system to prevent cyber risk, etc. So these all come under the role of risk management committee. So statement 2 is right. And statement 3, all the directors of nomination and remuneration committee must be non-executive. So regulation 19, it talks about nomination and remuneration committee. So as per this regulation, all the directors of nomination and remuneration committee, they are required to be non-executive. So statement 3 is also right. So the question is asking you, which of the above statements are correct? So you can see statement 2 and 3, they are correct. So the correct option is option B, statement 2 and 3. Now next question 3. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that we have also discussed this topic on our Telegram group. So we regularly conduct quizzes and post questions on that group. Also, a lot of relevant information regarding examinations is being shared. So do join the Telegram group and get the benefit. The link for the group is provided in the description section below. So question 3. As per SEBI LODR regulations 2015, every listed entity is required to have a policy for preservation of documents approved by board of directors. The documents have to be classified in at least two categories. One which need to be preserved permanently and second which need to be preserved for a minimum period. What is the minimum period specified? So LODR regulations, they stipulate that listed entities, they are required to have a policy for preservation of documents. And further, these documents should be classified into at least two categories. One for permanent documents which need to be preserved permanently and second which need to be preserved for a minimum period. And as per the regulations, the minimum period is 8 years. So the documents coming into the second category, they need to be preserved for a minimum period of 8 years. So the correct option here is option C, 8 years. Now next question 4, which of the below statements is incorrect as per LODR regulations? So here you are given 5 statements. You have to see which of them is incorrect. Statement 1, every listed entity is required to provide remote e-voting facility to all its shareholders in respect of all shareholders' resolution. So statement A, it is correct. So what is remote e-voting facility? So e-voting basically means electronic voting. So the shareholders can vote on a resolution electronically. And remote word means that shareholders do not need to be present physically at the company's office or at the AGM place. So shareholders, they can vote by sitting at their home or any other place through electronic means. So every listed entity is required to provide this facility to all its shareholders as per LODR regulations. So statement A is right. Statement B, every listed entity is required to obtain in principle approval from SEBI before issuance of a security. So this statement is not right because listed entities, they are required to obtain in principle approval from a recognized stock exchange. So approval is required from a recognized stock exchange and not SEBI, right? So in principle approval is required from recognized stock exchange. So statement B is incorrect. Statement C, the annual report of top 500 listed entities must consist of business responsibility report. So this statement is right. Top 500 listed entities are required to prepare a business responsibility report, BR report, as part of their annual report, and also top 500 listed entities also need to have a dividend distribution policy. So two things, BR report and dividend distribution policy. And this BR report is based on 9 voluntary guidelines. So this business responsibility report, it measures the performance of the company in terms of non-financial factors. So like environmental factors, social factors, etc. So basically this report shows how sustainably a company is working, because a company must not harm the environment, right? Then statement D, there should be a time gap of at least 30 days between two record dates. So you should know what is a record date. So record date are the important dates when important events happen. So like the date of distribution of dividend, or the date of issue of right share, or date of issue of bonus shares, or it can be the date when the company goes for splitting of shares, split shares, right? Or it can be the date when the company is merging with another company, or it can be the date of demerger. So the dates of all these important events, it is called record date, and the company is required to tell in advance these record dates to the stock exchange, that stock exchange on which the securities of the company are listed. So statement D is right, because there must be at least 30 days gap between two record dates as per LODR regulations. And statement E, the independent directors of the listed entity shall hold at least one meeting in a year without the presence of non-independent directors. So this statement is again correct. So there must be at least one meeting of all the independent directors, and in that meeting non-independent directors should not be there. So this meeting is very important, and in this meeting the independent directors are required to review the performance of the board, the performance of chairperson, and they have to ensure that there is flow of information between management and board, that management is providing adequate information to the board. So this is the role of independent directors which they have to perform in their meeting. So statement E is right. So you can see that statement B, it is incorrect. Now last question, question 5. So before discussing this question, I would like to tell you that I have posted a lot of quizzes on different topics for your Sebi Grade examination on our website. So you can attempt those quizzes and see your preparation level. Also, quizzes are available for other examinations like RBI Grade B, NABARD, UGC NET. So you can attempt those quizzes as well. So the link for the website is provided in the description section below. Now question 5, top 500 listed companies by market capitalization are required to include business responsibility report in their annual report as per SEBI LODR regulations 2015. The report deals with company's performance on 3 parameters. Which are these 3 parameters? So your options are ecology, sustainability, government, environment, social, governance, environment, sustainability, governance, environment, social, government, ecology, sustainability, governance. So guys, write the answer in the comment section below, then afterwards I will post the correct answer. So friends, if you have learned anything new from this video, then subscribe to our channel. Also, you can watch the previous videos in this series by clicking on the link being shown in the top middle of the screen. You can also download the PDF for this video. So stay tuned to our channel to get the benefits of more videos and updates. Have a nice day.